It's the glam show. Minerva is upset with me. Don't ask me why. She just didn't want to be in the video today. Oh, don't climb on it. Say hi and welcome to the glam show. I am Gabriella and I am your host. If you have seen this show, welcome back. Okay, I'm back. Minerva didn't want to be in the video. Also, I realized that I wasn't wearing anything on my lips and it looked dry. I promise I didn't just put makeup on for this. I actually had the only class that I have for sure met today. It was like orientation. Because our first year studies teacher is also our advisor for the year, so he met with us to go over registration and everything, and that was really cool. And I do put makeup on for my Zoom meetings, and actually I usually get dressed up because there isn't really a reason to get dressed up and put makeup on in quarantine other than that, so I'm gonna take advantage of it. But welcome back to the glam show. It's 4 o'clock here on the East Coast, which means it's about 1 o'clock on the West Coast of Pacific time. You will be seeing this at 5 o'clock Pacific time, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock my time. Still getting used to the time zone thing. This is the intro. I just wanted to say I'm not technically live, but I'm kind of live because I'm doing it on Friday. I'm not going to show you anything from this week because there isn't anything really. It's just been me here in this room doing orientation events that my school is putting on virtually for us, which has been really cool. Talking to my mom a lot on FaceTime, playing with my cat, and getting ready to register for my classes. That's what I have coming up this next week. Registration, and I'm really excited. And it's been a week since I've been in New York. Can you believe that? Like a whole week I've been in New York. It's crazy. Next week, by Friday, I will be officially done with quarantine on the 4th. So, and I move in on the 6th. So everything is really, really exciting. There hasn't been much going on for me, but there's been a lot going on in the world, like normal. It's been kind of crazy, honestly. I kind of talked about this 2 weeks ago, how everything that I'm doing is like good. Everything going on in my life has been positive, but there's still a lot going on in the world that is not exactly positive. I'm going to talk about that a little later after I do music and everything. I'm going to do music that I've been listening to in quarantine. I've been listening to a lot of music because in between Zoom and orientation stuff, I've been listening to music, eating. That's like the only upside to quarantine is getting all your food delivered. Delivered to me at my door because I'm not supposed to leave the room. I thought that was my cat. It was not. So it's like an upside is I don't really have to do much because I can't leave the room. But the downside is I don't get to do much, like go outside and explore the city. So tonight I'm going to do music in quarantine. I hope you guys had a decent week. And if you didn't, make sure you reflect on that tonight. And later on, we're going to reflect together about the week our country has gone through. So this week in quarantine, I have been listening to a few albums a lot. I've been listening to Taylor Swift's new album, Folklore, which I've already played for you, but this week she released her additional single that isn't on the original album. It's like the deluxe album. And Aminé's new album that he dropped this month that just like slipped my mind when talking about it in like the last few videos or last few shows. I hadn't even thought about it because I've had so much going on, but he released his second album after 4 years because his first album came out in 2016. I've been waiting for this. I played multiple songs by him on the glam show. A lot of you know, like if you know me, that I'm not huge into like modern day rappers and I don't know, like old school rap is my jam, but he is one of my favorites because I don't feel like he's necessarily like always rap. He's like R&B, hip hop. I really like his music. And so I've been blasting that one, Folklore, and then just some other songs, not really other albums, but those two albums for sure. So here we go. I'm gonna do, okay, so first, this is, I heard this on Instagram, on a TikTok reposted to Instagram. And I heard the lyrics and I was like, I heard like two lines and I was like, I need that song. Typed them in on Apple Music, got the song, been listening to it. This is Losing Control by Russ, and the intro's long, so I'm gonna edit that part out, but I'm gonna like listen to a good part of the song. I'm just gonna edit parts out because obviously you guys know that Facebook cuts you off, so I can't have too long, but the intro's pretty long. Playing the music on my laptop because I'm recording on my phone. So yeah, and then I will edit this on my laptop. Here we go.
She's falling in love now, losing control now, fighting the truth, trying to hide, but it's alright, girl.
Love that song. I don't know, like, it's like a sad, kind of, it's like kind of sad, but it's like, I don't know. I don't know. This is Taylor Swift, The Lakes. What I think is really cool is this week she has been releasing chapters. So kind of, you know how like when we group songs together, like for our emotions or something, she grouped her album into chapters. And this is from the Escapism chapter. This was an additional song that you got when you ordered the CD, but it's now available to stream. So this is The Lakes.
Is it romantic how all my elegies eulogize me? I'm not cut out for all these cynical clowns.
So good. Okay. Next I have I Hate You So Much by Alexander 23. Wait, really quickly, sorry. Going back to that song, I love how you can hear on the guitar, like her fingers moving. I actually took guitar for 2 years. Not a lot of people know that. I took guitar for 2 years in middle school, and I can still play a little bit. It was flamenco guitar, so it's not like regular guitar, but I still know how to play. And like, I just have to actually like learn songs, like songs that I listen to. But like, I love the way you can hear her finger. I don't know, I think that's just like a beautiful addition to the sound, right? Okay, so this is I Hate You So Much by Alexander 23. I've played you his music before. The one song I play all the time is Dirty Air Force Ones. Played that for you guys two weeks ago. And I think I've played some of his other songs before. This is his current single.
When I wish it was the truth, I hate you so much.
A little different than his other, than his album, I think. I think it's kind of a lot different than his album, but it's vulnerable and I like that a lot. Okay, this one has been on the radio for like quite some time, and like I don't usually listen to the radio, but the day before I left, I heard this driving back from Dutch and I was like, Mom, get my phone, write this song down. She's like, you know this song. I was like, no, but I don't have it like on my thing. And I was like, I need you to just find who sings it. And like, she didn't, but I was like, it's fine, I'll just type in the words. And so I did, got it on Apple Music. Yeah. Anyway, this is If the World Was Ending. This is the featuring Julia Michaels version, JP Sachs and Julia Michaels. And I think it's like, this is interesting to think about this song, because it's talking about, you know, like if the world is ending, would his ex come over, right? And like, it does both viewpoints, which is what Julia Michaels part is. And it's like, people have said like 2020 has been a crazy year, right? And a lot of people were like, oh, it's the world ending, right? So it's like, would you go spend some time with your ex that you still love if the world is ending? I don't know. I think that's what I got from it. But if the world is ending, I'd go to my family.
I was distracted,
and in traffic. I didn't feel it when the earthquake happened, but it really got me thinking, were you out drinking? Were you?
It's interesting because he's like, I know, you know, we all know, we both know we weren't meant for each other, but if the world was ending, you'd come over. I think that's really sweet. It's like sad at the same time, but I don't know, it's a really good song. Okay, I'm playing you three songs from Aminé's new album called Limbo, okay? These three are like my favorite right now. This one, the first one is Compensating featuring Young Thug. Young Thug.
Hey, you know why? You've been fucking with me since I was a small fry. And your X-Men, that's my little guy. I know some niggas that'll kick him to the coastline. I'm on West Side, nigga, we on show signs.
Okay, this next one is for my mama. Because when I heard this, I was like, oh. I love my mom and I miss her. Not that I don't miss my dad, but I miss my mom the most just because we spent a lot of time together. Like, most days I was with my mom. Not that I wasn't with my dad, but, like, yeah. Just our downtime, you know? I miss my mom. I love you, Mom. And I know she misses me. I'm doing pretty good, actually, in terms of, like, the missing people thing. I don't know. It's weird. I haven't cried that much. I thought I was gonna cry, like, a lot more when I got here. But I've been pretty good. Maybe it'll happen when I get to college. I don't know, but this is for my mom.
I gotta cry for my mama. Look where I'm at, mommy. Who would've knew? Sometimes I miss the days where you take me to school. Used to promise when I'm rich that I would get your favorite whip. You was my lift before the lift, so you deserve. You were cool.
I love that because he's talking about his mom and how, like, she deserves so much because she did so much for him. And, you know, I love that. Okay, this next one is called Becky. And I think this one's really... When I heard it, I was like, damn. It addresses interracial couples and how even though interracial couples, there's a lot now, it's still, there's still some people or some beliefs that don't really, aren't okay with it. Old values, old customs, you know, you don't mix, but love who you love whoever you want. But I think this is an interesting song addressing that, especially for the time right now, just because of everything going on with BLM. But yeah, this is Becky. And if you listen to any song off this album, because I'm recommending it to you, I'm telling you right now, listen to this one. It is, it'll make you think.
Mama said I never bring the white girl to me. Papa said niggas catching cases every week, so you best stay on your feet.
So, like, this next verse says, I'm fed up with them all. I'm fed up with my dogs. I'm fed up with the looks that we get in restaurants. I know it's not a law, but you know we ain't the same. I'm fed up with the world that I know I can't change. And then it keeps going, like, he's fed up with his family and people telling them that they can't be together. And, like, the first line, if you didn't hear it, is, Mama said, don't ever bring the white girl home to me. Interesting, right? But in this perspective, it's talking about how, you know, a white girl isn't going to know what he goes through as a black man. Interesting. Not that it's not true. It's just like, it's a very bold song. I think it's very, I think it's a really good song. I think it's something people should listen to because it's the things, that's something interracial couples go through sometimes. Okay, this next one was really popular on TikTok. It was on the radio. I thought I played it before, but I don't think I have. This is Say So by Doja Cat, and this is the remix featuring Nicki Minaj. Whenever I hear this song, it gets stuck in my head all day. I love it.
Yeah, you know it. Mm. It's the remix. Doja.
Oh my god. Okay, so this one, today, it came out today. It didn't come out today. This is off 5 Seconds of Summer their album that they put out this year, Calm, which I've played a lot of. This was their additional track that you get with the CD. Well, no, I don't even know. I didn't get it with the CD. It's like the deluxe, right? This is the 13th track on the album. It's called Kill My Time, and this is gonna be the first time I've heard it. So, real quick, I'm not gonna like make a lot of reactions with my face because that's just not how I listen to music for the first time. I listened to a song 3 times. Like, I'm gonna do that afterward. But so the first time I listened to it, I listened to the whole song as a whole. Then I listened to the lyrics and then the music, and then I listened to it again, and I guess 4 times, right? And then I listened to it again as a whole. I don't really react. I just kind of like take it all in. So if this is the first time I'm gonna hear it. If it looks like I don't like it, it's not that. It's just that I'm taking it in. Okay, so this is Kill My Time. Calm plus one. I'm so excited. Okay.
Wild, stop, finger to sun me. I can feel them still. Stained hearts, trying to find a home.
I can't listen to it all right now. That was interesting. It doesn't sound like any of the other songs on the album, so I'm kind of excited to hear the rest of it, but I'm gonna do that after this. Okay, this last one for you today is Conan Gray, because I have this one playlist with just his songs and Lennon Stella's songs, because whenever I listen to them, I get in this vibe, and so I literally titled it Vibes, and like, this is my favorite song by him right now off of his new album Kid Krow. It's not new, it was released this year, but I love all his music, but like this one is the one I'm listening to right now. Kind of reminds me of Here by Alessia Cara, because it's talking about parties and like how they don't really want to be here. But there's this one line that like I can't get out of my head right now because I'm 19. It's like 19 but you act 25 now. Okay, that sounded really bad, but it's 19 but you act 25. That's funny to me. Okay, this is Wish You Were Sober.
Wish you were so, wish you were so, wish you were sober. This partnership, wish we could dip. Go anywhere but here. Don't take a hit, don't kiss my lips. And please don't drink more.
So he's talking about someone that he's at the party with. He's like, I like that line, like, trade drinks but you don't even know her, right? Because something that my parents taught me when like every like the college entrance things I went through, don't trade drinks with someone because you don't know what's in their drink. And that's why I like that line. It's like, trade drinks but you don't even know her, like, what the hell are you doing, you know? Okay, so those are my 10 songs that I'm like listening to in quarantine. Again, I'm listening to Aminé's whole album, Limbo, and Taylor's whole album, The Lakes, or not The Lakes, The Folklore. But those are just some songs from those albums, and then I'm listening to the other songs mixed in with those two albums. That's it. In terms of movies and TV, I really haven't been watching a lot. I have been watching Gossip Girl with my mom, because my mom, before I left, we started watching Gossip Girl. She has never seen it. So we've been doing Netflix watch parties. Gossip Girl was the second show I ever binge watched the summer before 8th grade. I binge watched Secret Life of the American Teenager and then Gossip Girl. I don't know, I forgot how much went on in Gossip Girl, and I was like, dang, there's a lot going on in there. But my mom's watching it for the first time. Something she keeps saying is, are you sure these are high schoolers? I'm like, that's what it's supposed to be. It's a little extreme, but so Gossip Girl, and then also what else? Oh, we watched for orientation event, we watched The Perks of Being a Wallflower. That was pretty cool. Yeah, I think that's it. That's all I've been watching. So the last thing I'm gonna talk about tonight is this week. There was another shooting. There have been other instances of police brutality, but this one was caught on video, again, like the murder of George Floyd. And obviously, since the murder of George Floyd, the Black Lives Matter movement has gained a lot of traction. But there was kind of a lull, and I'm saying this because once people stopped their performative activism, it was almost like Black Lives Matter was a trend, but it's not. There are still people who are talking about it, obviously, because it's not gone away. This has not gone away. Jacob Blake, say his name. He was shot 7 times in the back. He is alive, but he's currently paralyzed and handcuffed to his bed. His father just released that statement that he is handcuffed to his bed and he doesn't understand why. He used the term chained because Black men and women were chained for a very long time. And he's handcuffed to his bed, but he's paralyzed. I don't really, you know, there was a march on Washington today. I think it's still going on, I'm not quite sure, but it was a protest. What I'm upset about is that it takes a video to spark things. Not to say that it's a bad thing, but my friends that are a part of the Black community have told me that they don't like watching the videos and the videos being shared because it's traumatizing and it's desensitizing it. We shouldn't, seeing a Black man or woman, a Black person being murdered or shot, shouldn't be something that's easy to watch. I didn't watch the last video because I don't need to see that video to know that it's still happening. Police brutality is still happening. So Jacob Blake, he's in the hospital. I am praying for his recovery. I hope that you pray for his recovery or you send him good thoughts, whatever you think, whatever you believe, whatever you want to do. There's a petition. Please sign the petition. There are multiple petitions that still have not met their goal. I think I'm going to put a few of the links in the chat when this is going so that you can click on there and sign petitions. It takes 2 minutes and there's a whole list of petitions and you can read about all of them. Black Lives Matter isn't just, it's a movement, but it's not just a movement, it's a real thing. When Black people say that their life matters, they mean it, and I mean it. And it's not just something to say. Like, you don't just say, oh yeah, Black Lives Matter, because it's a trend, because it's something that everyone is saying. You say it because you mean it. Black people do not deserve to be injured, killed, murdered for the color of their skin. They're human beings like you and me. And it hurts me that this is still going on. I can't even imagine how the Black community feels, because I'm not Black. I don't know what that feels like. Yes, I'm a person of color. But it's different. It is. And I know that. And again, that's my privilege. I'm recognizing my privilege. It's a privilege that I'm here in New York, that I was able to come, that I'm quarantining with a friend, that I'm going to college, that I don't have to worry about police brutality. Because I really don't. I look pretty light right now, in my opinion. I hope that you reflect on that. Reflect on what's going on in this world. So, if you don't like that I left the glam show off on this note, I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. This is happening on a day-to-day basis in our world, in our country. And it's not just because of the president. I'll be the first to say that. It's not just because of him. This has been happening for centuries. But the fact that it's still happening, even after all of the traction was gained after George Floyd's death. So, what are you doing? What are you doing to help? Sign petitions. Call elected officials. Talk to your family and friends. Share. Inform yourself. Educate yourself about what's going on. Recognize your privilege. Reflect on what's happened in the world this week. This is bigger than an election. This isn't a political statement. Black Lives Matter should not be a political statement. Because a Black person's life matters. every black person's right life matters. Whether they're a she, a he, a they, whatever they are, their life matters. They are human beings. And I shouldn't, like, we shouldn't have to say that. It should just be a statement. It should just be a known fact. And I don't need to say that. But I have some type of platform and I need to talk about it because I can. Because I can read and learn about it. Because I don't have to experience it directly. It's a privilege. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys next week. Next week will be, on Friday, will be my last day of quarantine. I hope you guys have a good week. Please remember, COVID-19 is still here. Wear your mask, wash your hands, be mindful of others, be mindful of yourself. Get tested if you think you're sick. Please take it seriously. Trust the facts. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next week.